here with Heather from Artisan Talent, and we're talking about front-end coding. Firstly, I'm a little ignorant. What is front-end coding, and how is it different from side or back-end coding?
Well, this is one of my favorite areas. So front-end coding or front-end development, anything, you know, with the HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery, those would be kind of terms that you would hear on a front-end developer's sort of resume and what they're doing. It gets a little bit more technical when you reverse it to the back-end side. So no side. That would be super
There's
fun.
There's no side
coding. No side. There's back-end or a front-end person, and the back-end would be more of your PHP, your Ruby on Rails, maybe you're a C-sharp or C++ sort of person, but that's the really nitty-gritty stuff to get it to the front-end, which the front-end are the people that actually connect with the designers to make things look visual.
Okay, cool. And I'm assuming here we're talking about websites and maybe apps, things of that nature.
Exactly.
Okay, cool. So let's talk about front-end web developer, web developers. What does a front-end web developer do? What kind of projects come across your desk that way?
There's a lot. This is an amazing space to be in across the nation, I would say. Everybody needs a front-end person to make designs visual, to make things updated, to keep things going. Mm. So we might get a project in, or maybe it's a long-term project. They just need, it's called a front-end developer. Straight and simple. There's other ways to call it too, but that's exactly what it is. And there's a designer and maybe people in the information architecture and back-end end that have created something. Mm. They needed it coded. So someone that has a desire and ability to sit there and be very intricate and detailed in creating clean code that others can look at, there's an art to it, and it's amazing. Once, if you do it well and if you do it fast, if you do it right, you're going to have a lot of people looking for you.
Okay, cool. I've heard these people called a front-end web dev.
Yes.
That's just slang.
Just slang.
All right, good. So what can a front-end web dev expect to earn doing this kind of work?
Wow. So this area has been growing. Some people want to get their feet wet, so you might have somebody that's green right out of maybe school, maybe out of a boot camp class or something like that, and they're like, I'm willing to do in, you know, the 30 to 40 range an hour. You have more seasoned people that are going to command in that 50 to 80 range hourly. As far as salary goes, you know, someone out of school, probably in that 50 to 55, and the sky's the limit on this. It depends on the client, so.
All right, cool. And front-end web developers, freelance or full-time or both?
Both. There are a lot of projects looking for people in that space. Maybe a concept has been created, maybe an idea has come up. Maybe a website just needs updated and they need somebody that understands that. So looking for someone like that. There's a lot of companies that have a development team connected to their creative team, and they look for full-time people or contract to hire, or maybe a fill-in during a certain project when they've gotten a certain client. Mm. So it kind of just depends. But you name it, that project exists. It could be an hour all the way through infinity.
All right, cool. And of course, you see a lot of these projects and full-time jobs cross your desk.
Yes.
Working at Artisan Talent, which is who we're here to talk about. Mm-hmm. So if someone, you know, instead of necessarily going out and trying to find a front-end web developer job or project on their own, if they want to go through a talent agency like Artisan, what's the benefit? How do you add to that?
That's a good question, because there is a lot of opportunity out there. We connect with different clients, and they maybe don't have that expertise internally, resources in finding these type of talent. So they reach out to people, you know, at Artisan that know these types of people and where they exist and how to get to know them. You do come across a lot of developers maybe at events, or maybe throughout, you know, different places around the city, and connect with them, or going to, you know, see something that they were part of. I'm listening to them speak about their work. And we've connected with a lot of those people and knowing where to look for them. So I would say an advantage is you probably won't find this job unless you're already connected to us.
That's a big advantage. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. So it might be worth connecting with a talent agency like Artisan. And you guys are everywhere, right? You're in Chicago, New York, I'm trying to remember, Washington.
DC, Indianapolis, San Francisco, and Los Angeles.
Great. And best way to reach out and connect with you guys?
Call, connect via web, LinkedIn, find us at an event, you name it, we're there.
All right, thanks so much for your help.
Thank you.